Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. Heavy snow on the roof prompted the evacuation of Milford High School this morning. The superintendent says around 7:30 this morning, a Milford High School teacher walked into her classroom and noticed a skylight had shifted. The fire chief says the ceiling dropped about 3 to 4 inches in an area where there's a heavy snow load, and one of the beams that was holding the skylight was broken. Students and staff were evacuated to the nearby middle school. There were no injuries, and now the school vacation, or school is on vacation, I should say. The school had a company scheduled to come in on Monday to remove snow, but that process is now being sped up.
We haven't had mass leaks, or we've monitored our hallways for cracking and things like that. None of that has been determined. So, frankly, we thought we were doing okay up until this point.
Personally, I feel the rest of the school is in good shape. It's isolated to that one room.
We were able to grab jackets and all of our backpacks, and that was pretty much it. We got out within a couple of minutes.
And with school on vacation next week, the school officials hope that's plenty of time to get the roof clear. They hope to have school open the Monday after vacation. A man clearing snow off the roof at a Merrimack warehouse fell through and suffered minor injuries. It happened this morning along the DW Highway. We're told he couldn't see the skylight covered with snow.
Well, when you're up on the roofs, you know, safety is first. You always have to be aware of where you are and your surroundings, and especially on commercial buildings or larger residential buildings that may have skylights that are covered. You know, you should do your homework before you go up there and find out what the hazards are.
It was a 40-foot drop down into the vacant building. The man's injuries, though, are not life-threatening. The freezing temperatures made fighting a fire in Hampton this morning difficult. This was the scene on Lock Road just after 9. Investigators are still determining the cause of the fire, but do say the snow made it difficult to turn off the gas meter there. We're joined by Jennifer Crompton with more.
Fire broke out at this home at 68 Lock Road in Hampton at about 8 o'clock this morning. According to the fire chief, crews responded right away but encountered issues right away with extremely high snow banks. He says the front door was completely blocked, and crews had a tough time just gaining access to the house. Once inside, there was heavy smoke and flames inside the walls. The chief says he does not know how this started yet. It'll be under investigation. One person living here had minor burns, was not taken to the hospital. Chief points out, too, that not only did the snow block the front door, it was blocking the gas connection to the house. It was under about 8 feet of snow. That's a concern because anytime there's a fire, they want to cut that gas off right away. He says it will be quite a while before we know how this fire started. Meantime, his firefighters are getting warmed up in warming buses that have come to take care of them. Never very safe to fight a fire in these kinds of conditions. We'll have more on this story later. For now, reporting in Hampton, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.
All right, Jen, thanks. Well, investigators are searching for the cause of a fire that left one person dead and another in the hospital after flames ripped through this Danbury home. Investigators say neighbors put one person from the burning home just after 7:30 last night. Ray Brewer spoke with the man who pulled his neighbor out of that fire.
Michael Mitchell and his friends were working on their snowmobiles in his garage when they heard the cry for help. They said at first it didn't seem too bad, but it wasn't long before everything changed.
I ran down there and I realized the house is full of smoke. There was some flames coming out of like the living room area.
It was around 7:30 Thursday night when Michael Mitchell went running to his next door neighbors. The couple at 24 Railroad Drive in Danbury were trapped by the fire. Not hesitating, Mitchell went into the home, barely able to see because of the smoke, and that wasn't all.
It was just hot, smell, burn your eyes just to keep them open, trying to breathe. It was just like someone sitting on you.
Guided only by the man's voice, Mitchell says he picked him up and carried him outside.
He told me then his wife was still inside, and my buddy and I tried to re-enter the house. As we got to the door, the house flashed over, went up in flames. We weren't able to get in to save her.
The fire would go to 3 alarms, bringing in firefighters from 14 towns. In addition to the fire, Danbury's fire chief says the cold also caused equipment to freeze, and water had to be trucked in from neighboring Bristol. Two firefighters suffered minor injuries, while the man suffered second-degree burns over the upper half of his body and was taken to a Boston hospital. His wife didn't make it, something that haunts Mitchell.
It's definitely rough, but at least we got one.
While Mitchell's upset he was unable to save the wife, the couple's son has released a statement in part saying, thanks to Mitchell and his friends, at least he has his father. In Danbury, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.
All right, Ray, thanks. Well, starting tonight at 5, a new push to change federal diet guidelines, what's being described as a more sensible approach. And NASCAR is racing into the classroom, the new curriculum it has created to get kids revved up over science and math. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.